Did you know you can do this? And this? With the Palo Alto, without any subscription, any license, any paid software, any cloud services, just with a Linux server?
That's brilliant.
In this video, I'm gonna show you how to configure a Linux server so that it requires the Palo Alto to show a new window asking from the user an OTP or a one-time password. The user is gonna get this one-time password either through Google Authenticator or SMS or email. This is configurable and this is going to be configured on this Linux server. So let's get to it. So guys, this is a new fresh Ubuntu that I just installed, and we're gonna install here the software called Privacy Idea. It comes already with the FreeRadius. This is a software that allows the FreeRadius to offer two-factor authentication. And we're gonna use this to do the 2FA on the firewall. And the cool thing is that you can do it as with the administrator login and also with Global Protect, for example. And then I'm gonna show you how to do both of them. And the first thing that we're gonna do, I have some scripts here already or some commands that I just need to copy and paste. I'm gonna leave them in the description so you can do the same. The first thing is gonna be a wget. Don't forget, first you need to be root on the server in order to give this commands. So I've downloaded the sign-in key. Now we need to verify the fingerprint. So it's AE250082. So it's correct. Now we're gonna add the sign-in key. Now we're gonna add the repository. Press enter. Now we can install Privacy Idea and the Privacy Idea Radius, the Apache 2 and the Privacy Idea Radius. This step takes a while. I'll be right back when it's done. And the next thing we need to do is to define the password from the user, from the administrator. So the command for that is pi manage admin add, and then you enter the username from your admin. Mine is going to be called admin anyway, so I'm going to just put like this. Mine is eadmin@localhost. So supposed to enter the password from the admin. And my username admin was registered successfully. I'm going to be using a local password for Privacy Idea instead of using LDAP. You can use LDAP in your company if you want or in your environment. For me, it's easier to have a local user for me to test the radius connections. So I'm just going to configure one. And for that, Privacy Idea has a command to create a file where Privacy Idea is going to find the username and password in there. So this is called, this is in opt Privacy Idea bin, and the name of the file is privacy idea minus create minus pw id resolver minus user. And if you do it with the minus h, you're going to see the options. And I'm going to be doing, my username is going to be called Ricardo. My user ID, well, it doesn't matter, 10. My password, Ricardo again. And description, user Ricardo, something like this. Press, no, I don't press enter. I write this information in a file called etc privacy idea underscore user, for example, something like this. So it has been written. Let's take a look at the file cat, and then I copy this, paste. That's the file that Privacy Idea created. This is somehow the password encrypted. And somewhere here is the ID and the comment. And here in the beginning is the username. Now we're going to jump to the web GUI from Privacy Idea. So we're going to open the browser and I'm going to enter the IP address from my server. There you go. Advanced. Proceed. I don't have any certificates. Of course, we just installed Privacy Idea, but at least we can see the login page, which is good. So I'm going to enter my admin user and the password that I just created. Enter. Privacy Idea is a good software, but it has some annoying things. For example, these windows, you can read them if you want, but they keep coming back every time that you log in. This is one thing that I don't like. And the other thing is that if you don't do anything for 2 minutes, you're already automatically logged out. 2 minutes, I think, is a little bit too short. So I'm going to show you how to change these. I'll just press no. Let's change these things first. We can go to config, policies. And here we're going to create a new policy. And I'm going to call it Web UI. Scope is going to be Web UI. We don't need to change anything here. Under action, we are going to search for hide. So we want to hide welcome info. And we're going to search logout, I think. Logout time. That's it. And here the default is 120 minutes. I'm going to set to 10 minutes. Sorry, 120 seconds, 2 minutes. I'm going to set to 600 seconds, so it's 10 minutes. And I'm going to save this policy. You'll be able to see here, so hide welcome info is true, and logout time is 600. These windows are not going to be shown anymore, and we won't be logged out so fast. This is the first thing. The second thing now, we need to create a realm, so we can go to config. Realms, and I'm going to create my realm default, create realm. There it is. Now we're going to add a new resolver. A resolver, I'll show you. This is under users. And here we're going to add a new resolver. You can have a resolver as a password resolver, so a user is going to be authenticated through his password. Username and password, which is somewhere locally. This is the one that we're going to set. You can use LDAP if you want. You can use an SQL server and some other stuff. We're going to click on the password resolver. And I'm going to call this, yeah, like it's showing there, resolver one is fine. And then we need to find the file that we just created. Let me go back to my Linux. And this is the one here. Let me see if I copied it. Yep. This is not this one. Sorry. I got the wrong one. This is this one here. There you go. This is the correct one. Save resolver. So after that, we need to associate this new resolver with the realm we created. So let's go to realms. And then here we need to click on edit. And you're going to click on the resolver we created. Set the priority, just set one, doesn't really matter. Click on save. There it is. I'm going to be sending my tokens through an email server. So I'm going to be creating here now SMTP servers. So you can have many ways to create your tokens, to send your tokens. I'm going to create an email token. If you come here to token and you click on enroll token, you have all these options here. You could be creating a TOTP, a time-based one-time password, which is the one that usually Google Authenticator uses. I've used this one before, but for this example, now I'm going to create an email token. I think it's more scalable. The problem that I see, I haven't seen any other solution with Privacy ID and this TOTP, is that the users, you as an administrator, you have to click on stuff here, and then pops up a QR code, and the user has to come with their smartphone and scan this QR code. So you have to be there to configure some things. As far as I know, it's not a self-service thing. Maybe they have one option like this, but I haven't found it. So I'm going to be using the email, so you can enter the email from the user and the user gets the information through email. I thought this one was more scalable, but this is not what I'm trying to do now. I need to go to config first, tokens, email, and then I have to configure an SMTP server configuration. Actually, the correct way would be through system, SMTP servers. So I click on it, click on new SMTP server, identify my SMTP server. I'm going to enter my stuff here, and I'm just going to jump this because you can create your own SMTP server. So my SMTP server has been created. Now we're going to jump to tokens, email, and I'm going to say that the email tokens are supposed to use this SMTP server in order to send the emails. And my OTP validity, I'm going to set to, 10 minutes. You can set whatever you want. Just going to save it. Now I'm going to have to set a token to my user. So you should go now to token, enroll token, email. I need your email address. Description doesn't matter. Realm default. The user is there. No pin. Enroll token. There is my first token. There's still one thing that we need to do is to configure our Radius secret key. And for that, we need to edit the file that's under etc FreeRadius. I have the version 3.0 and the file is called clients.conf. So I just click on it. Here, there is already a configuration for a client localhost. And I'm going to add one under that one. So client Palo Alto. IP ADDR equal 192.168.4.212. This is my management IP address and my secret. I'm just gonna call it PA secret 123, something like this. Okay, I'm gonna save this file. And I'm going to restart the FreeRadius. So systemctl restart FreeRadius. Yeah. So I think we configured everything on our back end. So now we need to go to the firewall. And I'll be right back. So now I'm at my firewall. First thing we need to do under policies, we need to allow. No, there's one thing before that. If you go to device, go to setup, and if you go to services, under service root configuration, we need to know which interface we're using for the Radius authentication. In my case, I am using management for everything, but it would be possible also to click on customize and come here where is Radius there to change this. So you need to check on your side which interface you're using for the Radius authentication. So in my case, it's management. So let's go to policies. And under security, I already have a rule. Where is my rule? Radius is called the rule. And this rule is allowing my management interface to access my Ubuntu server using the application Radius. So this is important. The next thing we need to do is to go to device under administrators. I have an administrator called Ricardo. I click on top of it. And the Ricardo is using my authentication profile called Radius. Let's go there. Authentication profile is there is the Radius, but the real configuration is here under Radius. And there, under radius, I already have my Ubuntu server. This is the IP address. My secret key I have to change now. PA secret 123. I think it was that, no? PA secret 123. Click somewhere else and then click OK. There I set my radio server. So I'm going to commit the configuration. And then whenever I log myself in with the Ricardo user, I should get something coming from the... No. There's one more thing that I forgot to configure, is the policy. So let's go back to Privacy Idea. So we're back here in Privacy Idea. There's one more thing. As I said, you go to Config. You have to go to Policies. You come here and click on Create New Policy. And then you, under policy name, you choose whatever you want, OTP. You have to choose here authentication. User realm, you choose yours. Mine was default. User resolver, I only have one. This one is usually a local node. And then everything else you can leave like this. Under action. Now, here's the real trick. You need to search for challenge. And we need challenge response. A challenge response, it's like this. When you authenticate on your file using username and password, the Radius server checks to see if the username and passwords are valid. And if yes, it sends back what it's called a challenge response. It's the second window that you see where you can enter your OTP that you receive from your Google Authenticator or something like this. So we need to activate this challenge response, and you can put a text. Here is email. If you're using something else, you can, as it's shown here, if you want something else like TOTP, you should enter here. But in my case, I'm just gonna enter email. The challenge text. No, this is not the one that I'm looking for. This is the one. This one is, I'm going to enter. Email challenge text. Please enter the code you received per email. Wait, now there's some more stuff. There's email. Email subject. I think you just received a OTP in my email text. So here there is a variable that you can use. It's shown here also. You can use OTP is the OTP you receive. I like to leave the OTP right in the beginning because, for example, if you're on the phone, you receive the beginning of your email message and you already have your OTP. Yeah, this is the trick that I like. If it's somewhere in the text afterwards, you have to open your email. Yeah, I just prefer like this. And there is more. OTP. OTP pin. This is very important. This one you need to use your user store. Whenever you create a token, you have a place in the token to define a pin, which could be any number, password, whatever you want. If you don't change anything here, it's not going to be asking for the password from the user, but it's going to be asking for the pin that the user has in its token. I don't really see the sense of it. And if you choose user store, then it's going to be asking for the password from the user, which could be a password in LDAP or wherever. In my case, it's the one that I used when I created the user. It's the same Ricardo you saw. And I think that's it. So let's save this policy. There it is. And now we should try to connect from the Palo Alto. So we don't need to restart any services. Here the commit is through. So let's log out and then we're going to log in again. Login. Now Ricardo password Ricardo login. Wow, it worked the first time. Please enter the code you received per email. This was, let's go in here, I have 10 minutes, OTP, action. I think you have to search for email. This is the email challenge text. Please enter the code you received per email. And let's open the email and check it out. So this is the email that I received. So as a subject, I think you just received an OTP, a OTP, okay. Should be an OTP. And this is the email subject. So an OTP. And let's go back to the email and blah, blah, blah is the OTP you received. So this is this text here, email text. Let's copy this OTP. Let's go back to the file now. Paste it. Login. There you go. It works. Pretty cool. The next step will be to try the same with Global Protect. So let's go to Network. Gateway. And I'm click on my gateway. I think I already configured it. It's under authentication. By the way, if you need some help configuring Global Protect, you can just click on the link on top of the top right corner of the screen to a video that I created, which will help you to configure Global Protect. So if you click on here, you can don't need to click. Authentication profile is already set to radius, so it'll be the same one. So I'm gonna just go to my client in the internet. I'll be right back. So now I'm at my client in the internet, and I'm gonna open my Global Protect, which I already have installed. Click once in it and go to vpn.netsums.com. Click on connect. My username was Ricardo. Ricardo. Click on connect. Yeah, there it is. Please enter the code you received per email. So now I need to open my email again. This is my new email. So I'm just going to copy this and paste on here and verify. And there you go. I'm connected. Thank you very much, guys, for watching the video. I hope you got some value from it. If you want, you can subscribe to the channel. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up. It helps me with the YouTube algorithm, also for more people to find a video like this. If you need some help with Global Protect, I'm gonna link here a video for you, and I hope to see you around. Bye-bye.